Hello, and welcome to Catholicity with Mr. Reno for Monday, February 8th, 2021, which should have been Friday, February 5th, 2021. We had some glitches in the Matrix, and we were unable to join you for follow-up Friday, but we're here today, and it turns into a follow-up Monday. We have a lot of responses to get into, so let's not waste any time. So I know it was a few days ago, but you'll recall that we basically were talking about Jesus's instructions for his disciples on their mission to go and spread the word of God, to heal the sick, to cure demons and expel bad spirits and things like that. And when you stay in that town, if they don't want to listen to you, then you shake all of the dust off of your sandals as a testament to them. So what do you think it meant when we read Jesus said, shake off the dust that is on your feet as a testimony against them? Lots of answers from our virtual school, the students at St. Kateri. I think he means like shake the sins off your body, in the essence that the sins of the people that they came into contact with, Grace says. And absolutely, the unwillingness to listen to the word of God is almost a sin when you know that it's coming from a place that can cure the sick and perform miracles. I think it means that they're probably getting rid of sins. I think it means to shake your sins off to get closer to God. Absolutely. Anything to do with getting rid of uncleanliness and sins is one way to look at it. Sammy says, I think he means by shake off any guilt you may have. Possibly the disciples might have felt guilty that they weren't able to change those people. Maybe all it means is to move on. And Ellie says that very eloquently too. I think that Jesus means that by shaking the dust off their feet, they're leaving the sins and demons behind them and moving on. Hope says, I think he means to shake off all the bad things and get rid of them. So sin, guilt, doubt. It symbolizes the uncleanliness there and not bringing the sin with you. Maybe they're worried that they'll walk into another town and that will follow them. I think that Jesus told them so that they would shake off the hatred kind of thing. I'm sure that some people did hate the disciples as they came through their town. So everybody's really on the right track. And perception and understanding personally of what Jesus said sometimes means more than what the smartest biblical scholars can tell us. This is what you took away from it, and this is what's important. So good job, students at St. Kateri. Moving on to the questions about discipleship. So there were two different ways to examine this. How do you show that you're a disciple? So something actionable that you can do or have done. Or maybe you have questions about discipleship. So let's go in order. What is discipleship? What is discipleship? What is discipleship? Well, Jesus called those disciples to be deputies of his word. Some group of people that can carry out the jobs that he has. So if we think of old Western movies, and it's hard not to think about that, all of these guys walking through the desert in the sand, showing up in a town where maybe they're not wanted. All of these guys are Jesus's right-hand men. They're all on the same page. They all understand the same message. They all have the same abilities. And that's what discipleship is in the Bible. So what is discipleship for us? Discipleship for us is acting that way. Being as close to Christ-like as we can. So how can we be a disciple, Hope is wondering? By doing just that. Acting like the disciples did as we read of what they did in the Gospels. Does simply helping and being kind to others show discipleship? Something as simple as that 100% shows discipleship. And there's nothing simple about being kind. It is a complex and challenging task to be kind to everyone that we meet. So yes, absolutely it does. Do I have to train to be a disciple? You have to practice. There's no training. It's whatever works for you. How can I show my discipleship to God and Jesus? by acting like Jesus did. Sometimes you see people with little bracelets that say WWJD, what would Jesus do? If we know what he would do, and we do it, that's how you can show it. What does it mean to have discipleship? Same thing. What does it mean to show it? What does it mean to have it? Even if I don't pray every day, or go to church every day, or read my Bible often, am I still saved? The only thing we need to do to be saved, and I totally appreciate the fact that this is an anonymous question, what do we need to do to be saved? We need to accept Jesus to be saved. Are there things that we can do to get closer to Christ? Yes, and you named them. Praying, being part of the Mass, reading the Scriptures, those help. What do we need to do? We need to accept that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. We need to accept that Jesus Christ died for us. We need to accept that Jesus Christ was resurrected after 3 days. This is our faith. This is in the Apostles' Creed. We are apostles, and this is what we believe. I could spread the word of Jesus, says Rylan, and I hope that you do, Rylan, because that is a surefire way to be a disciple. That's the main thing that the actual disciples were asked to do. Do you have to do anything special? Just be a good human. Be like Jesus. Follow the word of the Lord and learn from your mistakes. That's huge. That is huge. We all make mistakes. We all ask for forgiveness for our mistakes. And how does God help us to learn from our mistakes? Learning comes from reconciling with him, confessing, saying you're sorry, doing your best to not try to do it again. That is how you do it. I show I'm a disciple by praying and spreading the good news. Yep, that's how I do it too. If I respect others, no matter what, I am showing discipleship. Yes, if you respect everybody, that's huge. You could disagree with somebody. You could really be angry at what they believe, but you respect them as a fellow child of God. We are all brothers and sisters. We show respect. We pray for our enemies. We pray for people who don't believe what we believe, and that shows respect. I show discipleship by believing in God and Jesus. Absolutely. That is one big part of it. So thank you so much for your responses this week. Hopefully that clarified what discipleship means. Hopefully it clarified one of the things that Jesus says in one of his parables, his scriptures, his cryptic speaking, as it were. And we'll see you back again on Thursday for Jamboard Thursday. Take care.